I want her to be on the floor a little bit more, and I'm holding the bell thick, okay, because I want to make sure if she starts going that way, I can bring her back, right? Or if she starts coming this way, I can use my body to kind of bring her upright, but I've always got my hand on the bell. Okay, I would like to get you a little closer to the edge. Are you okay with that? I want you to try, this is your strong side, so I want you to try to scoot that hip forward just a little bit. Good job. Now, we're going to do the same thing on this side, and I'll help you if you need me. Excellent. So we don't want them, we don't want to say to them, scoot forward, because they'll do this. Okay? They will. And if they're in a chair, they'll use the back of the chair to push as hard as they can. Now their center of gravity is way out front, and they're going to just keep going. And we don't want that, right? So we want them to scoot hip, hip, hip. Because now their center of gravity is still in line with their base of support. Okay, does that make sense? So we don't want to tell them, scoot to the edge, unless they can do it right. If we've already taught them how to do it correctly, then we can say, you need to scoot to the edge. But they won't do that, try to push forward with their whole body. And they can't control their bottom when they do that. And this is when patients, when we tell them in preparation for a transfer, to scoot forward and then push way back, are they going to get up out of that chair? No. No. So they need to understand scooting forward means bringing your hips forward one at a time. And now it's